For the first time, OETA's cameras were allowed into the courtroom as justices considered the legal challenges to the budget measures. Here is more from the oral arguments that led the justices to strike down the cigarette fee in this ONR Extra.
You've given us a lot of contextual evidence as to the motivations for passage of this bill, and I don't think any of us are under any illusion that the budget crisis wasn't a key motivator. But we measure the purpose of a bill by its actual effect. So could you give me your best textual argument based on the text of the statute and explain to us how its text demonstrates that its primary purpose is the raising of revenue?
If you look at the operative provisions, it's plainly a tax. It levies the tax, provides for how it will be collected from the wholesalers, administered by the tax commission, used to support government functions, and subject to the tribal tax compacts.
This is an act relating to public health, providing short title, creating the Smoking Cessation Prevention Act, expressing legislative intent. It looks like the title in this, it doesn't sound like a tax bill.
In a constitutional analysis, the court does not just accept the characterization from the legislature, but makes a determination based on what the bill actually accomplishes. Here, the title is a characterization. What the bill actually accomplishes is levying a tax which raises over $200 million, which can be spent on government operations, and in fact, under the text, can be spent on things completely unrelated to smoking.
Short of completely banning smoking, this is the single best way to reduce smoking rates. And to think that the legislature can't do that, can't use an economic tool to do that, without having to go through the procedures of Article 5, Section 33, I think stretches Article 5, Section 33 beyond its purposes.
Well, if this economic tool that you want them to use, why do they appropriate such a small amount of money to do what you're after? And the bulk of this, vast majority of the funds simply appear to go to fund government.
The reality of the matter is that if you took all the money generated from this fee, put it into a pile, and set it on fire, it would still save 18,000 lives because of the effects on reducing smoking rates.
The problem that I have is, where do you draw the line? And we have to write an opinion in this case, and it seems to me that there just is no logical endpoint to your position. I mean, if the legislature discovers some behavior that it thinks is bad for the public, and it has some evidence that it's bad for the public, your view is that it can fee it out of existence.
Mr. Monsignani suggests, well, they could take the money and burn it. I don't know if that would really be legal, but it illustrates the point that you can regulate taxes, you can regulate cigarettes without creating the $225 million, which they had to have to balance the budget.